question is to you. So while you write about Mia, this fascinating character.
I think the frank truth would be that Mia is based on a couple of women I know, but all different women, fortunately. They are actually, but they've come on condition of being anonymous, so.
We'll leave it at that,
yeah. I think Alicia is there within each one of us to an extent. I think that's the beauty of it. I've just taken a condition which each one of us have. We are all different people at different points of time. The only thing which I have done is that I have exaggerated that to an extent to give drama to the plot. But I believe that each one of us have a Mia, a Tanya, and an Alicia within us. So yeah, I would say it is based on a lot of people I know.
Some of the books that have inspired you to write, to grow as a person?
As a matter of fact, the list is pretty long, I'll talk about it. But I must say that when you are writing a screenplay, you only have audio and visual. I mean, ultimately, that will be provided to you, the audio and the visual of the character. But when you are writing a novel, you can write the thought process of the character. You can give your own opinion about the situation and analyze it, which is not in the film. So it's a package deal. I mean, it has its advantages and disadvantages. So I suppose it's a different ball game. In all honesty, I must confess that I have written so many scripts, but I will be slightly scared if you ask me to write a novel. I don't know how I'll do that, whether I'll be able to do it. It is a different genre of writing. As far as my getting influenced or impressed by a particular writer or a particular book, they say if you are influenced by one, you are a plagiarist. If you are influenced by 100, then you are a research scholar. So thankfully, I was influenced by many. And another thing which is very important, and I would like to mention, that what happens when you talk to people who have read books and they talk about the books, they only give names of extremely respectable classics. But the fact is that anybody who reads only very serious and heavy literature, and only classical literature and names that are really revered and honored, is in trouble. You see, there is a chance that it may make you nirus. Because if you acquire it, your intake is so heavy and so much, it can bog down. It can bog down your sensibility, your life quality. It is equally important to read light literature. Now, we Indians tend to become very Puritans, you know, about comedy, about mystery, about detective novels. We feel this is B-grade literature. B-grade, even cinema. Perhaps we are not capable of producing a Charlie Chaplin, because however good the comedian may be, we will not respect him. I wonder if we are capable of creating a writer like Conan Doyle, because we'll think, oh, it's a mystery novel, it's a mystery, so theek hai hoti hai. Ye koi high literature thodi hai. It's not right. The fact is that I have been fortunate enough that I was born in a family where my father was a writer, my mother was a writer, my uncles were a writer, my grandfather was a writer, his mother and his father were a writer, her father was a... I am seventh generation of writers. Farhan and Zoya are eighth, and Farhan's daughter has started writing. So that is the ninth. So that is how it is. So your future, as far as the script is concerned, is there. So... So, you know, so I was brought up in an ambience, in an atmosphere where there were books all around and talk of literature. So that time in 50s and 60s, those were my formative years, decades, there was a very strong progressive writers movement in India. So that influenced me greatly. then I was introduced to, because to Russian writers, because my parents were Communist Party card holders who used to get all the Russian literature. So beside say Gorky or Sholokhov or Chekhov, I have read writers like Nikolai Ostrovsky and so on. So in my, I was 13 when I read Mother by Gorky. Then a writer like James Hartley Chase, when I was in college, he influenced me. And I have no shame in saying that if Brothers Karamazov or Dostoevsky or Dickens influenced me, at the same time I was influenced by novels written by James Hartley Chase. They were smart, they were quick, they were understatement, they had punchlines and so on. And I think whatever little screenplay I know, the technique of screenplay I have understood, these novels, these bestsellers that you get on the railway platforms have contributed a lot in that, because there, in those bestsellers, they are desperate to keep the tempo. They want to keep your attention all the time, while a classical writer doesn't bother about it. He says, all right, if you want to read my book, read, otherwise go to hell. But these people who are more, in inverted commas, commercial, have that desperate desire that they should catch your attention by the first line. So I have learned from that also, from great writers like Krishnachandra and Premchand, or say Tagore. So the influences are many. I mean, if you are sensitive, if you keep your eyes and ears and mind open, there is no dearth of inspiration or learning.
Karan Das, Indian counterpart, we have studied, both of us, Javed.
To match the curtains and the sofas. And in many houses, I used to see, now, thankfully it is over, the Encyclopedia Britannica, because it has that dark brown cover that matches the furniture. सच बताऊंगा आपको, जो मैं कुछ भी कह सकता हूं, लेकिन फैक्ट ये है कि जो बिल्कुल कंटेम्प्रेरी यंग राइटर्स हैं, आई एम नॉट मच फैमिलियर विद द राइटिंग, सो इफ आई गिव एन ओपिनियन दैट विल नॉट बी क्रेडिबल. आई कुड हैव थ्रोन एनी गुगली, बट मस्ट कन्फेस ऑनेस्टली दैट आई एम नॉट फैमिलियर विद दिस जनरेशन ऑफ राइटर्स. एंड आई कीप हियरिंग नेम्स एंड देयर आर पीपल हु आर have become very popular, but the fact is that I'm not familiar with their work. ऐसी तो बहुत किताबें हैं. You know, recently I was in London and I was walking on the Oxford Street with a friend, and I told her that when I was 16 or 17, I had read a novel, If I Forget Thee, and I don't remember the name of the author. And somehow, so I don't know who had written it, I don't remember the name of the author, but that was a fantastic novel. And I'm surprised why it was not made into a film in Hollywood. Now he has become an international star. So she said, okay, let's find a book. And within one block, she found a bookshop and she entered, and she told this gentleman who was sitting in the counter that the title of the book, If I Forget Thee.